Your heart is what is needed. Ask the Holy Spirit to come into your heart. Take charge and take control of your heart.
Holy Spirit,
so that the Word of God can make your life.
Branch of my
life. Let's open our mouth to begin to pray. Holy Spirit, let's open our mouth to pray.
Spirit,
ask the Spirit of God to come into your heart and take charge of your heart, your mind. Take charge of your heart. So that the Word of God may have a meaning in your life. So that the Word of God can have a meaning.
I invite you, Holy Spirit,
and that can cause a change in your life.
Take charge.
Let's open our mouth to pray.
That your word may reign in my heart.
Let's open our mouth to pray.
Dwell in my heart. Great.
Open your mouth and pray.
Have an impact.
Thank you, Jesus.
And have you
thank you, Holy Spirit.
In the name of Jesus.
Give you glory. We honor you.
Take charge.
We bless your holy name. We thank you, we give you glory. We give you all the glory. We give you all. This is Christ's supreme ministry. Let's quickly open our Bible to the book of Psalm 34, verse 17. The book of Psalm. Let's go to the book of Psalm 34, verse 17. The book of Psalm. The book of Psalm 34, verse 17. The righteous cry, and the Lord hear it. The righteous cry, and the Lord hear it, and deliver them out of all their troubles. The Lord deliver the righteous, the Christian. The Lord deliver the Christians, those who are righteous, from all of their troubles. Okay? The Lord, the Bible says in Psalm 34, verse 17, it says, the righteous cry, and the Lord hear it, and deliver them out of all their troubles. Talking about the issue of deliverance. Okay? We must let our people know, those people that need deliverance, and the person that need to be delivered, what must he or she do before she can be delivered, before he or she can be delivered. Because the issue of deliverance is just as if it's a controversial issue. Okay? You have heard what the Bible says. It says, the righteous cry, and the Lord hear it, and deliver it then out of all their trouble. It means the righteous men or women, Christian. And the people that the Bible is talking to here, not unbeliever. Unbeliever does not need deliverance as we used to say it in the past, as we see it everywhere. Why? Because they cannot maintain the deliverance. Those who need deliverance because they are troubled here and there, and the righteous men and women, the Christians, the believers, they are the ones that need deliverance. Okay? Because I've been hearing some pastors and some people who deceive their members that once you are born again, you don't need deliverance. It's a lie. Don't let them deceive you. Okay? Born again is just giving your life to Jesus, okay, and accepting Him as your Lord and personal Savior, and then receiving the Spirit of God as you believe in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. But that does not excuse you from trouble. That's what I'm saying. That does not excuse you from trouble, because what they are saying is that the righteous, once a man is born again, is free from all troubles. No. Well, you can see what the scripture says here. Okay? It said the righteous cry, the righteous. Not unbeliever. Unbeliever only need deliverance if he or she is ready to repent after deliverance and live for God. If you or she is not ready to live for God and according to the word of God, there is no need for deliverance to be executed on him or her. Those who truly need deliverance are the people of God and not unbelievers. Unbelievers that have been delivered, after some time, the same problem they are delivered from will come back in multiple numbers to their life. According to Luke chapter 11, 24 to 25. That is why those who really need deliverance are supposed to be born again Christians who are problems, who are going through one challenges and the other. But for you to say, or for any man of God to tell you that once you are born again, you don't need deliverance again, that man of God is lying. No matter how far they have come, they are telling you lying. Because you need to be delivered. If you are not delivered, there is no way you can practice your Christianity in a way that will better your life, okay, and bring glory to God. Speaking in tongue is good. Okay? All of these things are good. But for you to be genuinely born again and remain born again, okay, and remain with that born again, you must be delivered. Don't anybody deceive you that once you are born again, you don't need deliverance. Because as the scripture tells us here, he said, the righteous cry, and the Lord heareth, and delivered them out of all their trouble. The ministry of our Lord Jesus Christ is all about deliverance. It's all about deliverance. Deliverance, delivering people from darkness, delivering people from sickness, delivering people from poverty and the rest of them. It's not about Christianity, it's about deliverance. Deliverance is part and parcel of Christianity. In fact, the whole of Christianity is about deliverance. Whether by touching, whether by preaching the word, deliverance is being executed. Because deliverance is not using cutlass to cut somebody. Okay? Or using stone or cane to kill them. Deliverance is expected through the word of God. So anyone who tells you, oh, once you are born again, you don't need deliverance, that person is deceiving you. When you are born again, okay, when a man is born again, a man who is an armed robber in the past, who has stolen a lot of properties from people, who has stolen a lot of things from others, and those things are still with him. Okay, let's use an example of an armed robber who got born again today. Whether next week is he born again, as much as those property he has stolen in the past are still with him and he used to restitute, is not yet born again. No matter how he speaks in tongue. So if you are born again and you have spiritual husband, you have spiritual wife, you have sickness, born again does not take your sickness away. Listen to me. Don't let this pastor deceive you. Okay? We are prophets. We are prophets. And then you must have to listen to us. The Bible says in Hosea chapter 12, verse 13, it says, by a prophet they are delivered, and by a prophet they are preserved. You need the prophet to deliver you, or whoever that has the gift of deliverance, and the same prophet is also given the duty of preserving you, continue to deliver you until you get to the age of maturity. It's the same prophet that will teach you the word of God, or the pastor, or the evangelist, until you yourself get to the level or the stage of maturity, according to Acts 20:32. If an armed robber has stolen properties, or a man is sick of HIV, or a man is sick of fibroid, and that you born again today, fibroid will not automatically leave. You need to be delivered from that fibroid. So somebody says you are born again, you are speaking tongue, and then you don't need deliverance again from fibroid. The 90% of the cause of fibroid is a result of spiritual husband that give you fibroid. It is spiritual husband that give you fibroid. That's why you see when prophets are conducting deliverances, like in this church, you will see fibroid coming down. You will see menstruation that have been seized for 2-3 years. Okay, you will see blood instantly coming down. All those cancer that you have, who is giving them to you? It's cancer of the breast. It's spiritual husband who is sucking your breast. That's why you say, oh, I don't need deliverance, I don't need deliverance, I don't need deliverance. If a man born again, if a man is sick of typhoid, a man is sick of a woman is sick of fibroid, if someone is sick of HIV, someone is sick of tuberculosis, and the person got born again today or yesterday and began to speak in tongue, that tuberculosis will not go until it's delivered from that tuberculosis. That's what I'm saying. Don't let any man of God tell you, once you are born again, you don't need deliverance. I'm telling you. The major reason why you come into deliverance is because you have problems. And there are problems everywhere. And the Bible says the righteous cry out because they have problems. And God delivered them from all of their troubles. If a lady has a spiritual husband, like you are born again today, does not mean the spiritual husband will not keep on following you. You need to go for a deliverance exercise from a deliverance minister to deliver you. But I say all kind of deliverance. Somebody that wants to be delivered, you are asking that person to fast. What is it fasting for? For goodness sake. There is no need for that person to be fasting to be delivered. This is not scripture. All those people that Jesus Christ delivered in the Bible, you are not fasting. But now you put somebody 3 days, 5 days fasting, somebody will sick, says you should be fasting before you deliver. What kind of Christianity are you practicing? I don't know. And then, you see, many of you like lies. If you are not told lies, you will not believe. We like lies. And that's why African country is full of churches. But there's no changes. There's no changes. Deliverance those who need deliverance are the individuals who are able to maintain the deliverance. If you cannot maintain the deliverance that you have gone through, there is no need for you to go for any deliverance. For you to prepare for deliverance, you must also prepare your mind to be born again. If the word of God deliver you, you must try as much as possible to live according to the will of the word of God that deliver you. You must try as much as possible to live according to the word that deliver you. If you cannot live according to the word that deliver you, there is no need for you to come for deliverance. We are making mess of the issue of deliverance. Somebody is sick of cancer, and he got born again yesterday. He's now speaking tongue. He said he does not need deliverance again. What kind of pastor are you? And those of you that they are being told this, some of you are grandmas, some of you are masters. And somebody says, so you are born again because you are speaking in tongues, you don't need deliverance. Even myself, I need deliverance. Holy Spirit must deliver me everything. Okay? And somebody that wants to be delivered must not be asked to go through fasting again. If he has to go through fasting, what is the need of the person that wants to deliver you? What you need to be delivered, the things that you must have to know is that you must cooperate, okay, and then you must have faith to be delivered. You don't need to fast. You don't need to fast 3 days. When you begin to fast 3 days, you begin to fast 7 days. And then you say you are going through deliverance. You and the man of God, the so-called man of God, you are delivering yourself. That's not deliverance. You are just praying. That is what they call joint prayer. Corporate prayer. A man that has a fibroid, a woman that has a fibroid, a man that has an ulcer. You don't need to say the person should go through another form of fasting. That is inflicting more pains in the person's body. You are inflicting more pains. If you don't have the way we do, the gift of deliverance, let them go to where they can be delivered. Don't make them to remain in your church. Some of them will die. Some of them, after fasting, the fibroid will still be there, the ulcer will still be there. Nothing happened. What we need is that, number one, we must cooperate with the man or the woman that wants to deliver us. He must not force us. Deliverance is not by force. It shouldn't be by force. And then, secondly, we must have faith in God, not in the man. Because it is the God that wants to deliver us through the man that God has sent to deliver us. And thirdly, after we are delivered, we go and maintain our deliverance. But what we have heard is that, or what we have seen, is that some people will be made to remain in the church 3 days fasting there. That is not deliverance. Please. That is, you are cooperating with the pastor, okay, to pray together. If you want deliverance, you just come to the church, and the person who wants to conduct deliverance will deliver you without you fasting. What you need to do is that after you have been delivered, you go and maintain your deliverance. But now you see people going fasting 7 days, 3 days, okay, they may in the church, they give offering in the morning, they give offering in the afternoon, they give offering in the night. That is why many people don't like church any longer. We should preach the truth. If you want to be delivered, you go to the church, the day will be here marked for your deliverance, you will deliver. Once you are delivered, you see something leaving your body, the sickness leaves your body, you go and maintain your deliverance. Not that you are sick of ulcer, you are sick of malaria, you are weak, okay? And somebody now says, go through deliverance again. That is inflicting more sickness or more pains in the person. If you know you cannot deliver, let the person go to where they can be delivered. But the person you want to deliver must cooperate with you. It's not by force. And secondly, the person that want to be delivered must also have faith to be delivered. He must have faith to be delivered. And then thirdly, after you have been delivered, then being that you are a righteous person, it means you can maintain your deliverance. Being that you are a righteous person, righteous man or woman, after you have been delivered, it means you can learn. You can as well maintain your deliverance. That is why if you look at the book of John chapter 5, John chapter 5, John chapter 5, verse 14. Afterward, Jesus findeth him in the temple and said unto him, Behold, thou art made whole. Sin no more, lest it worst thing. See, if you want to be delivered, anybody asking you to pray, it's not deceiving you. Because if you're fasting 3 days and 7 days, and as well help you, you would have delivered yourself in your house. You would have delivered yourself in your house. So anybody putting you in the church, ask you to do 3 days and 3 nights so that you can be delivered, he's just deceiving you. He's not deceiving you. All those old way of deliverance has to stop now. Has to stop. That is not biblical. Okay, you pack yourself somewhere, somebody is sick, you see fasting, somebody has a problem, he's praying. Tell him to be praying, tell him to be fasting. Why are you supposed to eat well? And take water and get ready by faith to be delivered. If the person who is praying can eat and pray, or his prayer can help him, there is no need for you to deliver him again. This person couldn't deliver himself in all of his prayer until Jesus Christ comes and says, pack your bag and baggages and begin to walk. And the person began to walk. And Jesus met him afterward and told him, he said, Jesus finded him in the temple and said unto him, Behold, thou, he said, thou art made whole. Sin no more. Sin no more. What we should emphasize much as pastors or prophets or in quote, or so-called deliverer, what we should emphasize more is the cooperation of the person, the faith of the person, and the ability of that person to maintain the deliverance. You don't involve somebody in deliverance but by fasting. That means you are not gifted in deliverance. You don't have the gift. If you have the gift, the person you want to deliver may not to fast. Many people have been killed by asking them to fast. Somebody has ulcer, says you fast. Somebody is weak, you cannot move, says you fast. They're fasting. But after the person has been delivered, the best is to tell him or her that he should see no more, so that whatever he or she has been delivered from will not come back again to him. That is simple. It's simple. But now everybody say, I'm a deliverance minister, impact people in your church, you made them to be fasting. They look after the deliverance, there's nothing, no change. Somebody have breast cancer, say to be fasting. Somebody have ulcer, he says to be fasting. Somebody is weak, says to be fasting. Somebody has stomach problem, he says to be fasting. How can stomach problem person be fasting? Listen to me. That somebody, that something has been established. That something has been established that says it's true, does not make it to be true. Except it is in line with the word of God. The boy that was, if you look at Mark chapter 9, the boy that was having, what do you call it? This foaming in the mouth. Is it epilepsy? Did Jesus ask him to fast? Illiterate Christians. That's why you are where you are. Because there is no knowledge. No knowledge. Gambari Mafulani, you said, the one delivering you is a Fulani. The person who has been delivered is Gambari. So there's no case. Because you should know that if you are sick, somebody has to go through fasting and prayer again for 7 days, 3 days. The person just tries to kill you the more. If it's a true, genuine deliverer, let him deliver you without you fasting. And then your own duty is to go and maintain the deliverance. Luke chapter 11. No. And another thing I want you to know, you know. You can't hear Jesus praying that against somebody that wants to be delivered. Because spirit cannot die. The same evil spirit that committed your grandfather is the same spirit that is committing you today. You can't be Satan. Even God, the Bible does not tell us that God will kill Satan. He said he will be arrested in the last days and be judged and then be chained in the hell forever and ever. You cast out demons. You don't kill demons. They cannot die. Okay? You cast out sickness. Sickness don't die. You cast them out. Because at the back of every sickness, there is a demon. At the back of every cancer of the breast, every fibroid, there is a demon. That is why, no matter how you drink medicine, you do operation, you do this, the fibroid is still there, the cancer will not die. Why is it that cancer is a cause and untreatable sickness? It's because it is not natural. It's a spiritual thing. There's a spirit of cancer, which is called the spiritual husband or the spiritual wife. It's a spirit of cancer. The Bible tells us in Matthew chapter 12:29, it says, for this cancer to be healed, what you need to do is to burn the owner of the cancer and throw it away. I say, out! When it left or leaves the body, just small red and yellow cancer will cure the cancer. Don't be stupid, be wise. That's why the Bible says in Isaiah chapter 4 verse 6, Isaiah chapter 5 verse 13, and Proverbs 29 verse 18, it says Christians are still dying and perishing and living in poverty for lack of knowledge. Pray on the time. No. Too much of